and should sanctify.
Within your will, O Lord, all things are established,
and there is none that can resist your will. For you have made
all things, the heaven and the earth, and all that is heaven within the circle of heaven. You are the Lord of all.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen. The Lord be with you.
Today we're celebrating the feast of Saint Bruno, who lived almost exactly 1,000 years ago. He is remembered as the founder of the Carthusian order, a very particular form of religious life, which allows people to live a solitary life in community. Carthusian monks each have their own house and garden and workspace within a monastery where they gather together for prayer. Early in the lockdown, actually mentioned the Carthusian way of life as offering us an important message and example. The reminder that even when we are in our own homes, we can be there with the Lord. The Lord is with us. So let's pray today that following the example of Saint Bruno, we may look for those places and those moments where we can be with God, where God can be with us. Let's also say a prayer today for all the Carthusians throughout the world, for vocations to their order, and for the life of prayer and contemplation in the Church. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Christ,
have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who called Saint Bruno to serve you in solitude, grant through his intercession that amid the changes of this world we may constantly look to you alone. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. You must have heard of my career as a practicing Jew, how merciless I was in persecuting the Church of God, how much damage I did to it, how I stood out among other Jews of my generation, and how enthusiastic I was for the traditions of my ancestors. Then God, who had specially chosen me, while I was still in my mother's womb, called me through his grace and chose to reveal his Son to me so that I might preach the good news about him to the pagans. I did not stop to discuss this with any human being, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to see those who were already apostles before me, but I went off to Arabia at once and later went straight back from there to Damascus. Even when, after 3 years, I went up to Jerusalem to visit Cephas and stayed with him for 15 days, I did not see any of the other apostles. I only saw James, the brother of the Lord, and I swear before God that what I have just written is the literal truth. After that, I went to Syria and Sicilia and was still not known by sight to the churches of Christ in Judea, who had heard nothing except that their one-time persecutor was now preaching the faith he had previously tried to destroy, and they gave glory to God for me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lead me, O Lord, in the path of life eternal. O God, you search me and you know me. You know my resting and my rising. You discern my purpose from afar. You mark when I walk or lie down, and all my ways lie open to you. Lead me, O Lord, in the path of life eternal. For it was you who created my being, knit me together in my mother's womb. I thank you for the wonder of my being, for the wonders of all your creation. Lead me, O Lord, in the path of life eternal. Already you knew my soul. My body held no secret from you when I was being fashioned in secret and moulded in the depths of the earth. Lead me, O Lord, in the path of life eternal.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus came to a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. She had a sister called Mary, who sat down at the Lord's feet and listened to him speaking. Now Martha, who was distracted with all the serving, said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister is leaving me to do the serving all by myself? Please tell her to help me." But the Lord answered, "Martha, Martha," he said, "you worry and fret about so many things, and yet few are needed, indeed only one. It is Mary who has chosen the better part. It is not to be taken from her." The Gospel of the Lord. St. Paul is having a go at the Galatians for wandering away from the good news, and so he defends himself. He, as it were, lays out his credentials, and he's very honest about it, calling himself a persecutor of the church. But what he says in today's letter is that his mission was not of human origin. He quotes from the psalm that we also heard today to say that it's about God who chose him from his mother's womb. This should make us think once more of the idea of vocation, that the God who forms and fashions each one of us calls us for some particular mission. There's a phrase that St. John Henry Newman, whose feast coming up at the end of the week, used. He talked about some definite service. From before we were born, God created us with some definite service in mind. Now, finding blessing in this life and in the life to come is all about discerning and fulfilling our particular calling. That's something that the saints did. St. Bruno did that. He didn't want to found a religious order. All he was looking for was a way to fulfill what he felt was his particular calling from the Lord, to devote himself in solitude to a life of prayer. And St. Bruno's joy was that he was able to find a way to fulfil that calling. In the Gospel, we see again the idea of prayer being vital to the fulfilment of our mission. Martha and Mary are very different. In many ways, they balance each other. Yes, practical things have to be done, but not at the expense of prayer and contemplation. Mary, says Jesus, has chosen the better part because she was attentive to Jesus. Again, perhaps this reminds us of the life of prayer, perhaps especially the life of prayer that we see in religious orders like the Carthusians, where they balance the necessary work of every day, like Martha, with an awful lot of contemplative prayer, like Mary. Perhaps as we discern our vocation, perhaps as we continue to live out the vocation that we have claimed, we need to remember that balance, make sure that we're not too Martha or too Mary, that we balance things as we do the daily tasks that we have to do, but at the same time we are attentive to the voice of Jesus in our lives. In Mass today, then, let's think of these prayers, that all people may be able to discern and fulfil their particular vocation. Let's pray for vocations to the Carthusian Order and to other religious orders, and that we and all members of the Church may find that balance between work or activity and prayer or contemplation in our lives. We now place these and our own intentions for this Mass into the gifts of bread and wine to be offered to our Heavenly Father.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
In the
Lord's
presence, the Lord's presence, the Lord's presence,
receive our prayer, receive our Lord, we pray, the offerings made for the salvation of your people, so that through the intercession of St. Bruno, we may flee the enticements of sin and draw near to the company of heaven. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up your heart.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man. And when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we adore. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us,
Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Though we don't exchange a sign of peace, we pause for a moment to fill our minds and hearts with thoughts of peace for our world, for our society, for our community, for our families, our enemies and our friends. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
letters. Grant our request, we pray, O Lord our God, that defended by the protection of St. Bruno, we may live by the sacrament of your wisdom in serenity and moderation. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is over. Let us take Christ to the Lord. Thanks be to God.